is Naina from WAMDA.com. I'm here at the 5th Annual MIT Entrepreneurship Workshop with Yusuf Dukan of Flip Media. Yusuf, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Excellent. You just gave a fantastic talk. Let's just let's chat a little bit about what you talked about. How are government approaches to media in the region changing?
I think that they're changing in a lot of ways because I think they've realized that you just can't ignore this stuff anymore. And so what you find is you find interesting new things that are happening now where governments are realizing that they have to be more open and be more approachable, but to create intelligent ways to do it and valuable ways to do it that provide value both to the government, but also just as importantly to the citizens. So you see initiatives like the Saudi Ministry of Labor that has made such a conscious effort to become so much more open and so much more visible and so much more engaging with their audience, where they can actually share legislation with citizens for their feedback and really make their citizens feel like they're part of the conversation and part of the decision-making process.
So interesting. How is traditional media changing in its approach to social media?
I think traditional media is realizing that eyeballs and audiences are shifting away from traditional ways to consume it. So a lot of them are now moving into, they're still creating what we would call traditional media, be it TV or newspapers or radio, but they're finding more intelligent ways to be able to offer it to consumers. So you're finding a lot of broadcasters now are building very interesting digital products, you know, in terms of portals and so on, where you can watch their content but also interact with brands and do other interesting things. And so they realize, and you are seeing a lot of the biggest regional players now building their own apps so people can consume their terrestrial TV channel on the mobile channels. So all those opportunities are coming up now.
And just really briefly, what constitutes good social media practice? How can I get people to talk about my brand?
I think the reality is, you know, you've got to be who you are. I think kind of figure out who you are and be it. That's the easy answer, is that really, if you're a conversational brand, be conversational. If you're not, don't be. And, you know, you look at a lot of brands today, if they have a certain value, be it educational, be it entertaining, the brands that are the most successful are the ones that are the most true to who they are, but also adapt themselves to be on the web. So if you're a very corporate, boring business-to-business brand, create value-added content that can educate your audience. If you're a consumer brand and you're funny or interesting or cheeky, well, be it, and really feed off it with your audience.
Can you give me an example of how a B2B company could actually create that value?
Yeah, sure. You look at a brand like, for example, what are they called? It's a brand of blenders called Make It, and they have this YouTube channel called Make It Blend. And the really interesting thing is that they sell very expensive, high-end, industrial-strength blenders. But people are always obviously looking to or more willing to buy cheaper consumer-based products. So what they do is they created a YouTube channel called Will It Blend, where what they actually do is blend things like iPhones and shoes and CDs and cassettes to show you how powerful their product is and how strong it is, but at the same time creating entertaining content that obviously helps reinforce their brand values in terms of quality and durability.
Yeah, and it is really entertaining to watch the stuff blend. And just finally, the acquisition of Flip Media by Publicis Group is one of the year's biggest stories. What's next for you guys?
Well, for us really, this was never the end game for us. This is really just the next step in our evolution, you know. So for us, really, the trick is now to say, we've worked this hard to get this far. How do we now take this thing and really amplify what Leo Burnett can do in terms of communication, but also help us amplify what we can do in terms of digital? So it's really exciting, and we're already integrating. We're already finding clever ways to work together. We're always finding brands to work on together. So, you know, really watch this space. I think there's going to be a lot of good things happening.
Great. I look forward to seeing what you guys do.
Thank you, Nina.
Thanks for joining us.